So, Mr. Nicholas, welcome to Zambia, and please give us an outline of how you found the reception from the Zambia Rugby Union.
Well, as you may know, I'm in Zambia since almost a week. I had several meetings with Clemence Nkamba, the president of the Zambia Rugby Union. We discussed about, of course, the growth of the game here in Zambia. I also had the opportunity to discuss with the coach, with the captain. I actually had a training with a few of the kids and 17, 19 years old also, which are involved in the Get Into Rugby program. And I must say that I can see that I attended also a few games. I think yesterday, actually two rugby games here, two national and local team playing against each other. And I also attended a woman game. And I must say that clearly the rugby is booming here in Zambia. There is clearly a growing fan base. The number of players is increasing. The Get Into Rugby program is doing amazingly. I mean, in terms of it's truly reaching its objective, which is to not only grow the visibility of the game and grow the number of players, but also help some of the youngs, the youngster in the population, to learn about hard work and merits. And truly, I met today some players, including the former captain of the seven, which used to be involved in the Get Into a Rugby program, and they all told me how that program actually changed their life. It's pretty clear that they all say the same thing. Without Get Into a Rugby program, without rugby, I wouldn't have a job, I wouldn't have performed at school, I would have have a bad life. But now I learned discipline, I learned time management, I learned friendship. I learned that hard work is rewarded, and all the kids I saw have one objective, which is to represent their country at the national level and international level to play in big competition. So clearly, rugby is doing very well here in Zambia. So my congratulations to the team, the management, the players, and when you see all the youth which is involved in the game, well, I think the future of rugby in Zambia is very guarantee will be an amazing story.
So I'm sure coming to Zambia, you had expectations, and now that you've been here, you've seen and you've heard everything. Do you think you've met those expectations?
Absolutely, actually, even more than that. Because if you don't mind turning maybe your camera in that direction, you will see that that is a living proof that rugby is growing not only in Africa, but clearly growing a lot in Zambia. This is actually a proof, an investment of several million dollars, which is aimed to guarantee that rugby fans will be welcome here on that pitch, which is dedicated only to rugby. So when you see such initiative, when millions are spent like this to invest in the ability to welcome the fans and make better infrastructure for the fans and the players, clearly you can understand that the game and rugby is growing in Zambia. So I must say I'm amazed by what I saw. I'm amazed by the enthusiasm, I'm amazed by the professionalism of the people I met, and again, I think I will come back in a few years. I will follow that closely. A discussion with, as I said, Clemence Nkamba, the president of Zambia Rugby Union. We discussed, among other things, we discussed on how APO could actually support the Zambia Rugby Union. And I think they definitely deserve our support. So we'll do everything we can to not only push their communication, their mediatization, and use the example of Zambian rugby to promote African rugby, not only in Africa, but across the world.
Yeah, so when you compare the standards of rugby in Zambia and other African countries, do you think we are making any headways, to grow the game of rugby in Zambia?
Well, I think, each country is different. We have now close to 40 rugby federations. Each country is different, the infrastructure are different, the support you're receiving from the government is different, the potential of the population is different. Here in Zambia you have 13 million inhabitants, in some other country, of course, when you have 60 million, 70 million, 100 million, if you think about Nigeria, we just last year joined again the rugby family through Rugby Africa well, you can understand that the potential, when you have a potential, when you have hundreds of millions of inhabitants, of course the potential is larger. But if you consider the population of Zambia, I think the federation is doing quite well. I know the figures of the number of kids which are involved in the Get Into Rugby program. I know that a lot of efforts are made to teach rugby in schools. I know that, the Get Into Rugby program is definitely fulfilling his objective, which is to help the youth. I mean, some of the kids I saw today are kids which are, if they are not here in the field training, they are actually in the streets. And sometimes the parents are completely absent. So the word which, I'm visiting a rugby field here in Zambia, and the word which is coming the more often is family.
So going forward, do you have any advice or any suggestions for the Zambia rugby family going forward?
Well, I think it's time to show the world and show Africa that you are doing well, and I think you should improve work on your communication and had the chance to discuss with the communication manager of the Zambia Rugby Union. I gave a couple of advice, and I think we discussed about a few areas where we could improve things and show to not only Africa but show to the world that Zambia can be considered as as an example for the rest of the federation, and that again with such infrastructures which is growing from the ground and investments which are made, Zambian rugby has a lot to bring to the African rugby community.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.